Hi everyone, this is Knowledge Topper, and in this video we are discussing a very important standard that is related to accounting, and that is IFRS, International Financial Reporting Standard. So let's get into this video. So the question is, what are International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS? Like, I would like to give you an example first, so it will be easier for you to understand this. So if I talk about International Financial Reporting Standards, International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS, set common rules so that financial statement can be consistent, transparent and comparable around the world. Like, you know about cricket, and you know there are certain common rules in cricket that is mostly followed around the world, like a bowler bowls a delivery and as the ball hits the wicket, a batsman declares as out, or you can say a batsman hits a shot and if the ball directly crosses the boundary, it is given as a six. Or you can say if a fielder directly catch a ball hit by a batsman, it is declared as catch out. So these are common rules set by ICC, International Cricket Council. Same as in case of financial statement, assume preparing financial statement is a game and there are certain common rules issued by International Accounting Standard Boards, like short form is IASB. These common rules is known as International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS. So now comes to the definition. Like, as mentioned here, International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS, consists of a set of accounting rules that shows how transaction and other accounting events are required to be reported in financial statements, or you can say how companies must maintain and report their accounts by defining types of transactions and other events with financial impact. They are designed to maintain credibility, consistency, reliability and transparency in the financial world as well, which enables investors and business operators to make informed financial decisions. Like, IFRS standards are issued and maintained by the International Accounting Standard Boards and were created to establish a common language so that financial statement can easily be interpreted from company to company and country to country. Means it should be followed by one common standard so the reader of financial statement can easily understand about the financial position of any particular company in which they are interested. Obviously, and maybe they want to invest in that company, like buying shares of that company, so it should be easier, or you can say user friendly and understandable, like country to country and company to company, so they can easily understand wherever they want. So like, if we talk about further related to this, IFRS, International Financial Reporting Standards, are designed to bring consistency to accounting language, like practices and statements, and to help businesses and investors make educated financial analysis and decisions. And there's one important thing, like, I would like to tell you guys to that you are not confused. So the thing is that there is some rules that and standards that was previously known as International Accounting Standards, IAS. Now, IFRS are sometimes confused with International Accounting Standards, IAS, which are the older standards that IFRS actually replaced IAS. IAS was issued from 1973 to 2000. Now, if you talk about further related to IFRS, you know there are a lot of different financial reporting activities, like there's a statement of financial position, a statement of comprehensive income, a statement of changes in equity, a statement of cash flows. So there is a lot of statements that we have to prepare, and these all are financial statements. So IFRS covers a wide range of accounting activities. There are certain aspects of business practice for which IFRS set mandatory rules. Like, if we talk about statement of financial position, we all know that it is also known as a balance sheet, and IFRS influences the way in which the components of a balance sheet are reported. If we talk about statement of comprehensive income, this can take the form of one statement, or can be separated into a profit or loss statement, and a statement of other income as well. that includes property and equipment. Then we talk about a statement of changes in equity. It is also known as statement of retained earnings. This documents the company's change in earning or profit for the given financial period. And at the end, a statement of cash flows is also there. Like, this report summarizes the company's financial transaction in the given period, separating cash flows into operating, investing, and financing activities. We already done cash flows. So if you want to know about cash flows or income statement balance sheet, you can watch my videos, my previous videos that I already uploaded. So we generally use IFRS while preparing these financial reports. In addition to these basic reports, a company must also give a summary of its accounting policies. Like, the full report is often seen side by side with the previous report to show the changes in profit and loss, and you can say it shows the comparison between the 2 years or between the past years. So this is the video for all of you guys. I would like to let you guys know about international financial reporting standards. Hope you learn from this, hope you understand this quite easily. Thank you so much, everyone. Like our page, subscribe our channel Knowledge Topper, as well as like our page on Facebook and join our group as well. So this is it for you guys. Thank you so much, everyone. It's time to say bye bye.